Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In this lecture, we will learn about the fourth chapter of teaching of English, the lesson planning. After completing this chapter, students will be able to understand the importance of lesson plan and they can prepare comprehensive lesson plans of prose, poetry, vocabulary and grammar. And language teaching pedagogy with your knowledge of our learners. The curriculum and teaching context. It is a time when we envision the learning we want to occur and analyze how all pieces of the learning experiences should fit together to make that vision a classroom reality. A lesson plan is a step-by-step guide that provides a structure for an essential learning. Before planning a lesson, it is essential to classify the learning outcomes for the class. It is important because it helps the teacher in maintaining a standard teaching pattern and does not let the class deviate from the topic. Lesson planning is the ability of teacher to visualize and forecast into the future of what, why and how of the teaching learning process and how an effective teaching learning process can be occurred in a formal setting. Now we will discuss about the need and importance of the lesson plan. Lesson plan gives teachers the opportunity to think deliberately about their choice of lesson objectives. What he or she want to teach their students, what behaviors she want to teach their students, she adds in her objectives of the classroom. The types of activities that will meet these objectives, which type of activities can be used to achieve the desired objectives, teacher can design in advance. The sequence of those activities, the materials needed, how long each activity might take time, and how students should be grouped. These are all the things that a teacher can plan in advance before the delivery of the lesson. So, lesson plan helps the teacher to decide all things in advance to prevent from the haphazard teaching. Teachers can reflect on the links between one activity and the next, the relationship between the current lesson and any past or future lessons, and the correlation between learning activities and assessment practices. Because the teacher has considered these connections and can now make the connections explicit to learners, the lesson will be more meaningful to them. So, for the effective delivery of lesson and teaching learning process, lesson planning is too much important. The lesson planning process allows teacher to evaluate their own knowledge with regard to the content to be taught. टीचर जो है वो इन एडवांस प्लानिंग करता है, इन एडवांस उसको अपने नॉलेज का पता होता है, वो पहले से ही कंटेंट, मटेरियल, एक्टिविटीज, ईच एंड एवरीथिंग कंटेंट से रिलेटेड जो है वो जमा कर लेता है, उस पर होमवर्क कर लेता है कि उसने किस तरह से पढ़ाना है, कितना पढ़ाना है और कौन सी एक्टिविटीज़ के थ्रू पढ़ाना है और कौन से ऑब्जेक्टिव्स हैं जो वो फुलफिल करना चाहता है. इफ़ अ टीचर हैज़ टू टीच फॉर एग्जांपल अ कॉम्प्लेक्स ग्रामेटिकल स्ट्रक्चर एंड इज़ नॉट श्योर ऑफ द रूल्स, द टीचर वुड बिकम अवेयर ऑफ दिस ड्यूरिंग लेसन प्लानिंग एंड कैन टेक स्टेप टू एक्वायर द नेसेसरी इंफॉर्मेशन. Similarly, if a teacher is not sure how to pronounce a new vocabulary word, this can be remedied during the lesson planning process. So before the lesson delivery, teacher जो है वो हर तरह की अपनी planning जो है वो कर लेता है. and it helps him or her to teach effectively in the classroom and help him to avoid the haphazard teaching in the classroom. This opportunity that the lesson plan presents to evaluate one's own knowledge is particularly advantageous for teachers of English for specific purposes, because these teachers have to be not only language experts but also familiar with different disciplines like business, engineering, medical, and etc. that use language in specialized way. So they can design their English language lesson before the delivery of the lesson. A teacher with a plan then is a more confident teacher. जब एक टीचर के पास टीचिंग प्लान होता है, लेसन प्लान होता है, तो कॉन्फिडेंटली वो अपने लेसन को डिलीवर करता है, क्योंकि उसको अपने लेसन का ईच एंड एवरी एस्पेक्ट जो है वो क्लियर होता है कि उसने कितनी देर में कौन सी एक्टिविटी करवानी है, किस एक्टिविटी के थ्रू पढ़ाना है, किस तरह से स्टूडेंट्स का फीडबैक लेना है, किस तरह से स्टूडेंट को इवेल्यूएट करना है और फीडबैक देना है, उसे टाइम को जो है वो सेट किया होता है, डिवाइड किया होता है, और उसके अलावा कंटेंट पे उसकी मास्टरी होती है, वो अच्छे तरीके से कंटेंट को डिलीवर कर सकता है. द टीचर इज क्लियर ऑन व्हाट नीड्स टू बी डन, हाउ एंड व्हेन. द लेसन विल टेंड टू फ्लो मोर स्मूथली बिकॉज ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन हैज बीन गैदर्ड एंड द डिटेल्स हैव बीन डिसाइडेड बिफोर हैंड. The teacher will not waste class time flipping through the textbook, thinking of what to do next, and droning to make photocopies. The teacher's confidence will inspire more respect from the learners, thereby reducing discipline problems and helping the learners to feel more relaxed and open to learning. Teacher should know the materials that he or she going to use in the delivery of the lesson, that all are available to help you teach for success. Make sure the availability of the materials, take and keep an inventory of the materials and resources that are available to you. For example, technology, software, audio visual aids, teacher mentors, community resources, equipments, manipulatives, library, resource book, help book, guidebooks, gesture speakers, volunteers, and any type of materials that can assist you in the effective delivery of your lecture. Teacher should plan the material and should make sure that she has all the material with her in advance. Now, planning for instruction. In the planning of instruction, some following points need to be considered. Content: list the important facts, key concepts, skills, or key vocabulary terms that you intend to cover. You can also prepare an outline with key learning outcomes. Remember to refer your curriculum guides. Number second, set your goals. Identify the aims or outcomes that you want to teach your students to achieve as a result of the lesson you plan to teach. Goals are end products and are sometimes broad in nature. Goals relate directly to the knowledge and skills you identify in part one in the content. Number third, objectives. Teachers should set specific objectives related to the lesson. Identify the objectives that you hope your students will achieve in the task that will engage them in the learning process. Objectives are behavioral in nature. They are the behaviors that a teacher desires to teach their students, and they are specific in the nature. Objectives tell what you will be observing in student performance and describe the criteria by which you can measure performance against. In many ways, objectives represent indicators of performance that tell you to what extent a student is progressing in any given task. Objective आपको बताते हैं कि student जो है वो अपनी performance में किस हद तक mastery achieve कर चुका है. जो आपके डिजायर्ड बिहेवियर हैं या ऑब्जेक्टिव्स हैं जो आप स्टूडेंट को सिखाना चाहते हैं, उसमें किस हद तक उसने मास्टरी अचीव कर ली है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इंस्ट्रक्शनल ऑब्जेक्टिव्स कैन स्टार्ट विद अ गिवन दैट डिस्क्राइब्स अ कंडीशन दैट इनेबल्स योर स्टूडेंट्स टू परफॉर्म एनी टास्क. इट कुड बी एन एक्टिविटी, अ स्पेसिफिक सेट ऑफ डायरेक्शंस, मटीरियल्स नीडेड टू परफॉर्म अ टास्क. इट कुड बी एन असाइनमेंट और एनीथिंग दैट सेट्स अप अ कंडीशन फॉर स्टूडेंट्स टू एंगेज इन द टास्क दैट कैन बी ऑब्जर्व एंड मेजर्ड फॉर परफॉर्मेंस. ऑब्जेक्ट्स कैन रेंज फ्रॉम इजी टू हार्ड टास्क डिपेंड ऑन द स्टूडेंट एबिलिटीज. So teachers should design the objectives from easy to complex. Number third, materials. List the materials and resources that will be needed for the lesson to be successful. As we have discussed earlier, teacher should know the material what she want to use in the classroom, and she should make sure about the availability of the materials and technologies that she want to use to achieve the objectives. Then introduction. Describe or list a focusing event or attention grabber that will motivate your students to want to pay attention and learn about what you plan to teach. This will depend on the ages and stages of the students, and it will rely on students' interests and backgrounds. So remember, getting your students to attend and respond to your introduction will set the stage for the rest of the lesson. Next one is the development. Describe how you plan to model or explain what you want your students to do. Modeling the learning behaviors you expect for your students is a powerful development tool and provides demonstration that students can then imitate or practice on their own. During development, models of teaching are used to facilitate student learning. Model can include direct instruction, inquiry, information processing strategies, or cooperative learning strategies. Number 6, practice. List or describes ways in which you will provide opportunities to your students to practice what you want them to learn. Give them opportunities, better chances they have to master to expected outcomes. These opportunities are in classroom assignments or tasks that you give them the chance to guide and monitor the progress. Then independent practice. List or describe ways to provide opportunities for your students to complete assignments to measure progress against the goal of instructions. Remember to only plan for tasks that you believe students can accomplish without your guidance. Let them do their work by their own. Only give them guidance, facilitate them and mentor them, and let them their work by their self. Then accommodations. List or describe ways that you will differentiate instruction according to students' need. Always keep into consideration the individual differences of the class of your students. So plan your activities and instructions according to the students' needs. Some students are audio, some students are visual, and some students are audiovisual and kinesthetic. So always keep into mind the interest and the styles of the students' learning whenever you are designing the lesson or planning a lesson. Number 9, checking for understanding. List or describe ways that you will check for understanding. Assessment and ongoing feedback are necessary for monitoring the progress of the students. Ongoing assessment, formative assessments can be used for this purpose. This can you the different techniques that a teacher can use for the assessment can be questioning, conferencing, or journal writing, reflection writing, etc. Next one is evaluation. List or describe ways that you will assess or measure students' success in achieving the outcomes that you plan to reach. This can include a variety of ways to evaluate students' performance. Number 12 is teacher's reflection. This section is to be completed after the delivery of the lesson. It represents what you think worked or what did not work and why. It is meant to give you some insight into practice, and it will hopefully help you to make adjustments and modifications where necessary. It gives a true reflection of your teaching, of your delivery of lesson, and you can maintain the flaws in the remaining lectures and in the upcoming lectures, the things that you need to more maintain and acquire more mastery on the necessary or needed tasks or things. Here are example of a good lesson plan. There are a number of templates for good lesson plan. Here is an example of a good lesson plan. It should include the lecture's name, the course which you are going to teach, the subject unit. It should mention the lesson planning topic, aim of the lessons, lesson objectives, prior knowledge of the students, and your teaching way, teaching methodologies that you are going to adopt to teach the lesson, and resources that you are going to use in the effective delivery of the lesson, and the assessment patterns that how will you assess the student's performance after the effective delivery of the lesson. It also should include the date on which you are going to deliver the lesson, the duration, the time period, and the level to which level you are going to give the lecture. Different skills, communication literacy, different activities, details of the activities, and different technology details and resources or material details that you are going to use, and the information technology that whatever you are going to use in your lesson should be included in your lesson plan. Here is a format of a lesson plan. There are a number of formats that can be used for the effective lesson planning. Here is an example of a format and a template of a format that you can see in this picture. It has intended learning outcomes that a teacher wants to achieve in the classroom, assessment of the students' learning, data collection, methodology, materials required, and strategy for misconceptions that she can use.